Hey, Jaap here from Skinny River Fly Supply. In this series, I'm going to show you how to tie better flies. So without further ado, here we go. Today we're going to tie the Hobo Spey in the Skinny River Lodge variation, which is tied on a tube and with slightly different materials than the original, which was tied on a hook. We're going to start with going through the materials. Materials are very important in your flies. You want to make sure that you start with the best possible materials, otherwise it's very difficult to tie a good fly. So you're going to need some French tinsel. I like it in small, and I like it from Vivus or Lagarten is good too, because it doesn't spread apart when you pull on it. Then we need some hot orange tying thread. We need some cactus chenille. Can be any kind of brand. I like it to be quite good size, medium or large, and you can pick the color that you like. I'm having a kind of a soft orange peachy color today. We're also going to use some of this straggle with fairly long legging on it, and it's going to be used instead of the dubbing that was used in the original pattern. Then we're going to need some accent flash. I use it from Hedron, and we're going to use some polar flash, also from Hedron, and I use it in a pearl. Then for these feelers that you see here, we're going to use Lady Amherst center tail feathers. And for the under hackle, we're going to use large guinea fowl feathers like these. You want to make sure they're large, because with a wide diameter tube, it's difficult to have a long enough feather. I use them from our Skinny River Fly Supply brand, which has only large guinea fowl feathers in it. Then we're going to use some standard marabou in pink and orange. For the head, I use some Sally Hansen Hard as Nails lacquer. And that's it. And then we need the tubes. For the tubes, I want to talk a little bit more about. These are tied on a 1.8 millimeter tubes. Originally, these tube flies were not really designed to tie on small diameter tubes like that. So many people started tying on hard inner tubes that are used for inner tubes into 3 millimeter tubes. That's not ideal, because these tend to break. So if you're going to tie directly on a 1.8 millimeter tube, tie on a tough tube. Our tough tubes are very soft and very flexible, and they won't break. So that's what we're going to use for this pattern. Okay, first we're going to place a tube onto the mandrel. You slide the mandrel onto the tube, and we're going to place that into the tube holder. Leave about the length of the fly outside of the tube holder. Tighten it up here. Then we're going to tie in our thread. Just like that. Clip off the end. Then we're going to tie in our tag end, which was the cactus chenille. Tie it in. Make a good base there. Then tie the cactus chenille while pulling the fibers a little bit towards the back. 3 or 4 turns. Like that. Nice big, I like a nice big tag end. Like that. Catch your chenille with your thread on the bottom of your tube, then tie that off, clip off your cactus chenille, And that's your butt end of your fly. Clean it up a bit and bring it all the way back against your butt there. Then we're going to tie in the body materials. First is our straggle. Tie it at the bend, back end, like that. Lay it out of the way. Then, next thing, we tie in our French tinsel. Out of the way, there. And then thirdly, we do our large guinea fowl feather. Grab it at the tip, pull it back a little bit so the fibers flow back and get rid of all the fluff here in the bottom. And then you tie that in. And what I like to do here, I tie it forward a little bit and then I grab the tip, pull it back and tie that so that it's really tied in solid. Then we bring the thread forward like that, but not too long. Make sure that your body, you don't make it too long because you will not have enough material and the length of the body that way is not that important. So make it about that long, maybe three times the length of that butt end. Then we're gonna first start with our straggle. And again, I kind of pull it back like that so that it aligns nicely. And I space it a little bit out. So this is one of the changes I made on the original. I just find that this is gives it a nice amount of leggy action on the body. Very quick, very durable, and without having to do all the dubbing steps. You can do the dubbing if you prefer that, but most of this pattern, the dubbing disappears behind the marabou wing, so it's not that crucial. Tie it off again there. Then I pluck that out a bit like that, and you see there's some gaps in there. Don't worry about that. I like that because I don't want this to be too thick. Then this feather is going to be tied in those gaps. See, and then you don't see them anymore. And I try to bring these out as much as I can. Nice wide spacing. And I don't pull too much on this. I just let it fall the way it wants so that it's kind of unruly. Tie it off. And this one, I like to tie it back like this. Place it like that and then tie it off. That gives it a nice strong connection. Then pluck it out a little bit again so that it's perpendicular to your tube. Then you take your French tinsel and you wind that in the opposite direction all the time, wiggling a little bit like that so that it doesn't trap too many fibers. You need it, you can do that a little bit like that. Then tie that off again. And same thing, I like to tie that counter. In this case, because this ends up all the way under your wing later on. And then we have our body ready. You can pluck that out a little bit. If you want, you can use a brush to kind of brush that out a little bit, like so, to make those legs come out a bit more, like that. Or a Velcro brush, whatever you prefer. It doesn't matter what, you can do it like that. Either works, and then we have a nice full body like that. Then the next step is going to be our marabou wing, and we start with the orange. So we're going to take just a small part like that of the wing, and I like to pull that away a little bit from the tip like that. Then we tie that in like so. Tie it a bit forward your thread and then bring that tip material back again to make a more secure tie-off point. Then clip up the tag end there. Doesn't come very accurate. You don't have to clip that close. Then same thing, you pull this back and you start winding it forward. Like that. And keep bringing that nicely back, like so. Continue that. Sometimes you have to pluck that out a little bit so the fibers don't get trapped too much. There. Until you're at the end. Then you tie that off. And one or two against it, like that. And then clip it off. Again, it doesn't, you don't want to have it too short and too close to it. Pluck that out a little bit, like so. If there's some fibers trapped, you can pluck that out a little bit with your scissors. There. Got some trapped under there. Okay. So that's it. Then the next part is going to be the pink overwing. I like that to be quite thin. So in this case, this is a little bit too much material. So I'm going to pull that away a little bit, like that. So that is just very thin. Then we do the same thing. We tie that in there. Fold it back. Clip off the tag end and tie it forward. Tie that off. And here you start to have to be a little bit more accurate with how many turns you use and how close you clip. This one I clip a little bit closer because here we're getting at the front of the fly that you're going to see at the end. Okay, so that's the wing and the body. Then the next part is going to apply some accent flash. I just grab about 3 fibers of accent flash, like that. I let them extend a little bit past the wing, tie it off, double it and bring it over. You can see that there. I'm going to bring it over, so I double it and then tie it off. I do that one more time on the bottom, about 3 strands. And tie them. You want to make sure that they stagger a little bit. Tie it off. And then double it again in about section of 45 degrees. 45, 45, 45, 45 around the fly. Then the next is going to be to use some of this flash. Again, about 3 or 4 of those strands. Stagger them a little bit by pulling that down a little bit, like that. The length, just about the length of the wing, and then I'm going to stagger that in between the accent flash. One there. I just look where there is no accent flash yet, and that's where I'm gonna put this flash. And then I again stagger it a bit by clipping it at different lengths. And then we're gonna do one more on this side. These patterns are tied with a fair bit of flash. Okay, done. You can check if there's anything unruly too long here at the end. maybe that one, clip that off there. Then the next step is going to be our Lady Amherst, and we're just going to clip these long barbs off at bunches of two at a time. I like them. Here we have clipped off two of those fibers, and I like to put them on there with the curve going out, so you have a real leggy thing happening. There's two ways of doing this. You can tie these directly in like this, trap them under your fly, and that's how I like to do it. And I'm going to show you an alternative way. I find this strong enough and it's neat and small. You can also do this in reverse by going with the points of the feather going outward. Tie that in at 45 degrees of the other. Tie it in like that, outward. And then fold it back. That holds a little bit better, but it ends up being a slightly thicker way of doing it. And for this pattern, I prefer to do it directly in a smaller way. So we're going to do that twice more here with the curve going out. Oh, we're trapping some flesh there. There. And one more to go. Make sure you got that evenly spread out over the quarters of the fly, like that. All right. Then make sure that everything is nice and neatly wrapped up, and you have a nice orange head. Then whip finish it. I just use my hands, and that will be the fly, like so. Make sure you seat that nicely by pushing that back towards the camera a little bit there. That will seat your knot nicely. And then just clip it off close to the head of the fly. Then last step, a little bit of Sally Hansen lacquer. And I apply that all the way over top like that. Rotate the vise there. Then I put my finger along it, there, done. Now, one more thing, this we can now take out of the vise, like so, remove the mandrel, like so, and then we can clip off the front end, there, for the rear of the fly, of the tube. I always like to tie on full tubes. You see how long my tube was? I can move this whole tube through there and keep using tube material so that I don't waste too much. This way I don't have to pre-cut lengths. And I like, in this case, for this pattern, to leave a little length behind the tag end. Either to put junction tubing on or to use a loop knot that will jam up at this point of the tube. So then you're going to tie a knot that's going to jam up against there, and your hook will dangle here nice at the tail end of the fly. And that's your whole fly like that. I hope that was useful for you and that you learn maybe a little bit from it. Next time we're gonna tie probably the Formula One to show you some different. All right, so that was the Skeena River Lodge variation of the Hobo Spey in the pink variation. You can do these in all kinds of variations. A very popular one is an orange head with a black front hackle and a blue rear hackle and chartreuse butt. That's also a very good pattern for here. I hope you learned something from this and that you enjoyed this video. If you would like to see more of these videos, please subscribe on the button below, and I will also leave some information for you in the text below on links on where to find materials and what materials are used in this video. Hope to see you next time.